Hello everyone, we'll discuss Jainism today. Before we start with Jainism, I must tell you that Jainism and Buddhism are quite similar to each other, and both of them are supposed to be a religion which was a response to Brahmanical orders. Because Hinduism at that time, by the end of later Vedic era, had become so dogmatic that people were, you know, not very comfortable to continue as a practicing Hindu. There were so many karmakands, rules and don'ts and dogmas. They tried to read these scriptures, the Vedas and Upanishads, but they could not comprehend anything out of it. So they needed something which is user-friendly. So Buddhism came and Jainism came. So Jainism is older than Buddhism, we must remember. Reason because before we proceed, we must know the meaning of this term. Tirthankar. Who are Tirthankars? Tirthankars are the Jain gurus, and their position in Jainism is even higher than God. These are the Jain gurus. So the first Tirthankar was Rishabhdev. And till date, there have been 24 Tirthankars. Mahavir Jain was the 24th and the last. 23rd was Pashamath. Remember that these two, Parshvanath and Mahavir Jain, 23 and 24 are historic figures, whereas the first 22 are mythological. This implies that there is no historic proof of first 22 Jain Tirthankars. Jainas go by their belief, but history has no proof. History, however, has proof of Parshvanath and Mahavir. So, first 22 are mythological, the last 22 are historic figures, which means they were born, they died, they lived. History has proof. So, Jainism also talks about lifestyle, a certain code of conduct for its followers, and they are again, there is no mechanism of any elaborate worship or rituals in Jainism like Buddhism, and I told you that these two religions are very similar to each other. So, Mahavir also left his home. He left his home at the age of 30 years. And he also wandered. He wandered for many years. And then he attained the ultimate knowledge. Something very similar to what happened with Buddha. He got Kaivalya. The ultimate knowledge. So, when he got Kaivalya, he became Jinna. Jinna means conqueror of senses. The word Jain is derived from Jinna. The one who has conquered his senses is Jinna, and this word comes from Jinna. So, Jainism has asked its followers to follow a certain lifestyle, and there are two main divisions of Jainism. Shvetambar and Digambar. Shvetambar are the white clad Digambar are sky clad. Shvetambar are those Jains who wear only white clothes. They don't wear any other color, they just wear white clothes. That is why they are called white clad. Digambar do not wear anything at all. Anyway, they are sky clad because they have dig. Dig means 10 directions. This word dig means 10 directions. We know about 4 directions, but if you go for a 3D, there are 10 directions. For Niche Samilati, 10 of them. So, the one who has, you know, just draped himself with all the 10 directions, the sky itself does not need any cloth. That's why they are called sky clad, they are called white clad. So, these are the two main sects of Jainism. And they preach non-violence, they preach compassion, they are against accumulation of wealth. So, Jains do not, Jainism does not allow accumulation of wealth. It's for a reason, aparigraha is the term that they have used, that whatever is needed for more than your consumption should not be kept by you. So, please don't accumulate wealth is what they say. One of the basic tenets of Jainism is this. At the place where the Jain monk resides is known as Sthanagas, the abode of the Jain monks. That's a very brief introduction of Jainism. That's all for now. Thank you.